get to know me. You don't know me at all. Feel so lonely. The world is spinning round slowly. There's nothing you can show me from behind the wall. 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 You don't know me. Bet you'll never get to know me. You don't know me at all. Feel so lonely. The world is spinning round slowly. There's nothing you can show me from behind the wall.
Hello guys, welcome to the vlog. It's Sunday. I just had some breakfast. Weege is here being fabulous as always. Just having a little sleep on the chair, aren't you? Yes, he is. Yeah, it is Sunday. Not much to update you on. It's obviously still locked down in the UK. I know, still locked down in the UK. So I'm just mostly bored to insanity. But anyway, sort of vlog. This vlog is also going to be sponsored, and I'm very aware that you had a sponsored video last time as well. So I'm sorry that's come two on the bounce. It's just worked out that way. And this one is going to be sponsored by Jewellery, who you know I work with a lot and wear their stuff all the time. So I hope you guys don't mind, but I am aware it's not ideal having two sponsored videos on the bounce like this. But yeah, I've got some pieces from Jewellery to talk to you about. As always, I'll have my promo code for you guys too, which I will put in the description box. And yeah, we'll do that later in the vlog. What shall I talk to you about? Oh, Luigi has been gifted some things. I can't believe it. A brand called Lily's, which I think does cat and dog food, messaged me on Instagram and they said, would Luigi like some treats? I thought, would he? So he's been sent lots of food, lots of cat food. Some of it's Christmas branded. This one, Lily's Kitchen Christmas Spectacular Turkey and Ham Feast with Cranberries. Oh my god. But more importantly, Luigi has been sent a kitty advent calendar. I don't even have an advent calendar. It's obviously just full of treats. It's got chicken treats with liver and turkey treats with cranberry. I am so excited to give him this. It's giving me a whole new lease of life for Christmas, which I'm sure will be short-lived. You all know I hate Christmas. So that was very exciting, both him and I. We're quite thrilled about that. What else is there? Oh God, honestly, there's just so little to talk about. Even with friends, I'm like this, when you know, you have like a weekly catch up with people and you're like, so, weather's nice, just kind of it. But I have been watching The Crown, obsessively so. I'm actually on season 4 now. I did all 3 seasons in a week and a half, which, this is actually quite depressing when you say it out loud, but it is just so good. I just am so hooked on it. I think about the Queen all the time now. I had a dream about Princess Diana last night. They're in my dreams. It's just so, so, so brilliant. And we've only done for the first episode of season 4, but I'm very excited to get more into it because it's got Gillian Anderson as Margaret Thatcher. Gillian Anderson is just incredible. And all the Diana juiciness, so that's what mostly I've been doing, if I'm honest, and doing some work as well, but in between making sure I'm very au fait with the royal family. I also spend the entire time Googling what actually happened and photos of what everyone actually looks like while I'm watching as well, so that has been good. Literally really don't have very much to say, so I'm just going to check in again later. We could talk about books, in fact. Finished last week Ghosts by Dolly Alderton, which I think will be one that lots of people read. I loved her debut there, Everything I Know About Love, Everything I've Learned About Love. I think it's the first one. I loved it so, so, so much. This one I didn't enjoy as much. It's actually incredibly bleak. Like, by the time I got to the end of it, I was like, oh, there was just, it just felt really bleak, if I'm honest. So I didn't love it that much. I got off to a good start with it, and it's a really good, nice, light read. So I really enjoyed it for that reason. But like I said, by the time I got to the end, I was a bit like, oh. And now I'm currently reading Never Let Me Go. I'm forgetting the name of the author, which I am loving. It's such a me book where kind of not that much is happening and everything's bubbling under the surface, which I really love. I believe it was a film as well. The book is, the author is, oh, Kazuo Ishiguro. Kazuo? Kazuo. Anyway, Ishiguro is the surname. And yeah, I'm absolutely loving it. And I think I'll watch the film once I've finished the book, because I don't think I've seen the film. It's got Keira Knightley in it and Harry Mulligan. So yeah, that's my reading update. Battery's flashy on this, so I'm going to go charge this so that later on I can vlog more about the nothingness that is life. And just been really enjoying wearing them. But I have other pieces to show you. So I'm going to do that now and possibly change my earrings. Let me just find lots of my jewellery boxes living in here. Let me just find the new ones. These are what their boxes look like, by the way, if you've never seen them. They're really, really simple. So in here I've got two very fine gold hoops. And this one is a really nice fine necklace. One second, it's all, it's got them tangled up. Can you see? It's like the, this thickness of chain is in between the thickness of these two. Can you see? This tiny one is, it's so hard to show on camera because of how tiny it is, but it doesn't have like a chain pattern on it. It's more of a solid, just not a bangle obviously, but just more of a solid piece of gold. Whereas this in thickness is in between the two of these. So a little bit thinner than that, but I think that will look really nice with that one. On this one that I've got in here, I have my chain extender on with it, which was a thing I talked about from a jury quite a while ago. And I'll also link in the description box because it's such a simple thing, but I think it's one of the best things they do. It's just a as you would imagine, a tiny chain extender, which can make the pieces a bit longer, which if you have a few pieces is really good for layering them up. This one is quite long anyway. That's actually shows really well the different thicknesses. Their chains are just so beautiful. I love how fine and how simple they are always. Okay, so hoops, I'm going to put these in now. I have two different sized, so I'm kind of going to create the effect that these have. I do have enough piercings to, I've got my lobes pierced numerous times, but if you didn't and you only had one piercing, then these ones that I've just taken out would be a really, really good option. What I like about this is that it's a full hoopy circle as opposed to being, I mean, this works for this design, but you know, when it has the back on it, I think in a really simple hoop like this, it's quite nice when it's a full circle. Now bear with me while I fiddle getting these in. I can't do it without a mirror. Okay, that's one in. So it does come down a bit bigger than the other one, and for the little one. So also guys, Jewellery have a Black Friday offer on at the moment. All the details will be written on the screen now and also in the description box below. So if there's any pieces that you've had your eye on for a while or anything that I'm recommending in this video, now would be a very good time to get it. All for gifts. I guess they're quite good for gifts because it's so simple, you kind of wouldn't get it wrong for somebody, especially if it's someone with either starting out a jewellery collection, actually it's a good foundation, or with a big jewellery collection. But just having nicer quality stuff is so nice. Oh, do you ever feel like you lose the back of your piercing? Okay, that's another one in. My ears are going to be really red after this. I've got such sensitive skin to touch. All right, guys, have them all in. Which do you prefer, the first ones I had in, which are the single earring, or the line of hoops like this? Like I said, if you've just got your lobe pierced once, these ones are brilliant for that, for you to get this look without having to have all the piercings, which I think is such a nice idea. But yeah, as always, I'm just such a big fan of their jewellery. Like I said, I can really vouch for the quality of their pieces as well. I've been wearing mine for so long, so if you've had your eye on something, I guess Black Friday would be a good time to maybe take the plunge and treat yourself to something new. I think if I have to, my ultimate recommendation out of all the pieces that I've got from them is probably this chain, the thicker one. It's just, I literally don't think I've taken it off in over a year. It's so good. It looks great with everything. This is the chain extender. But this lighter one, obviously, that I've just shown you now, is a really, really nice option if you want something more delicate as well. But their chains are just brilliant, including the bracelets as well. But generally, I think maybe a necklace adds more to an outfit or your day-to-day style than a bracelet would. So if I had to recommend one thing, it would be their chain necklaces. But obviously, I'm a big fan of it all. So big thank you to Jewellery once again for working with me. It's such a joy to have recurring and returning clients like this. And yeah, all the Black Friday information will be in the description box for you to get a bit of a deal on that as well. I'm just gonna finish getting ready now. I'll show you my outfit, and then I need to walk to Labyrinth on Bethnal Green to pick up some contact sheets for a project that I've been shooting, which I'm actually really excited about. So I had contact sheets done, which I don't normally do, but I wanted to do some collaging, so I need to go and collect them. And it looks like it's a relatively okay day today, thankfully. So it should be a nice little walk too. Hello guys. I've got a green juice because I am the vision of health. Fitness is my passion. I just went to pick up some contact sheets for a project that I'm shooting for Tag Heuer, which I'm super, super excited about. My AirPods coming out. Oh no. Oh, that was tricky. Just around the corner from home, as you can see. Slept really well last night for the first time in a few nights, so I'm really pleased with that. Couldn't make me feel shitty. Also, have I said this already? I've gotten so addicted to the new Assassin's Creed. I close my eyes and I see Vikings. Although I've just gotten to a new bit of the story where I'm in England and I don't know how to cope with it all. Oh, that was my handbag falling off my shoulder. I'm doing too much multitasking here. But yeah, I am hooked on Assassin's Creed. Why did no one tell me before how good this game was? Any of you, why did none of you tell me? And only now am I discovering it after 2020 could have been a year of Assassin's Creed, but it looks like this is going to bleed into 2021 at this rate. Anyway, just let myself in the house and have a sit down. I've not walked far, but I'm acting like I've just run 10k. So Weege and I have begun the mince pie testing for this year. I've done a co-op one, who they always rank very high. This here is a Tesco's Finest, which I actually am preferring to the co-op ones this year. This is my second one of these. Ignore that, that just happened. So far between co-op and Tesco Finest, Tesco is in first place. I will at some point today do a trip to Sainsbury's and make sure all of the major supermarkets, as always, are competing and see how they do this year. But well done to Tesco. Weegee, come here. He's not going to come over here. He's busy playing with something. Weegee, do you want to come get this? No, too busy. This is his absolute favourite toy. Has a few colours and he runs around like mad with it and then loses it somewhere. What have I got, Weegee? Your favourite one. And he also carries it in his mouth. It's the cutest thing. Weegee? What is it? Do you want to show everyone how good at chasing you are? Go! Oh, you didn't get very far. Go on, Weegee. Come on, you're showing me up here. Go! Oh, yes, Weegee. Catch him.
There's nothing you can show me from behind the wall. 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 of war. You don't know me, bet you'll never get to know me. You don't know me at all, feel so lonely. The world is spinning round slowly. There's nothing you can show me from behind the wall. Show me from behind the wall. Come on and show me from behind the wall. Show me from behind the wall. Come on and show me from behind the wall.
Show me. Nothing but trouble. Oh, I'm gonna drop you. Let's not do that. Off you go. Why are you being so naughty? Hey? Lots of you have been asking about if he's seen Frank. Obviously, he can't let Frank in anymore, but Frank keeps coming to the door and meowing. The guilt is killing me. And we saw him a few nights ago and puffed up his tail and was giving it in more of a what for, which is good, that's what you need to do. However, the size difference in them, I think maybe you need to wait till you're a bit bigger to pick those battles. But yeah, I went outside and gave Frank a stroke and tried to explain why he can't come in anymore, but who knows if he understood. It's Wednesday today, it's so dark and miserable, it feels like it's nighttime inside the house. I'm actually going to have to put the big lights on, which I rarely have to do, which is just really miserable. Yes, it is Wednesday. Obviously, why are you all puffed up there? Why's your tail all gone bushy? What? What's the matter with your bushy tail? What do you want? He slept curled up to me all night last night, which was very, very lovely and special. Today, in today's episode of things that I should know better than to attempt to do myself again, I'm going to be cutting my fringe with nail scissors at some point. It's in desperate need of a trim. I'm going to grow my hair, I think I've said this already, and I've ordered some, like, you know, you get those, like, vitamins that are meant to make your hair grow. My friend Kim used some that she said were really good. I'm just going to pop me down on here. So I've ordered some of them to hopefully make it grow, which means the fringe will need trimming more and more and more. But it's in desperate need right now. What? What? Come on, why are you being like this? Who's that? Who's that? Can you see? Haven't you grown so big? Haven't you? You're so big. So big. And you're so busy. I can see you want to get up onto these shelves you've not been onto before, but you're not going on there. Ouija's not allowed everywhere that Ouija wants to go. Which is every corner of the house, isn't it? That means you ought to be put down. He's got his second vet appointment next week for his second round of vaccinations, but he's definitely healthy and happy, eating like a horse, and just being very, very playful, and just so cuddly at night, which is my favourite thing. Yes, it's lovely, isn't it? We love a cuddle. Did I tell you guys I'm addicted to Assassin's Creed? I did yesterday, didn't I? I just think about it all the time, and every all day is just spent marking time until it's an appropriate time in the evening to start playing a game. What? To climb up there? Unfortunately, not much else to update you on. We are nearly at the end of lockdown, but if I'm honest, the whole thing kind of feels a bit pointless because. And we although we've had really good news about the vaccine, I think everyone's attitude needs to remain in a lockdown kind of one, even over Christmas if possible, despite the rules that they've updated. So it's just a bit like, get out of there! Even though lockdown ends next week, which is a good thing. It's not, you know, it's not the final date for anything. Out of there! Weege man. Hello guys. Changed into comfier clothes, a hoodie basically. The hair things that I was talking about have arrived from JS Health. Honestly, Kim showed me a photo but before she started taking them, and then a month after, and her hair had grown so much, so I'll let you know if I have a similar success with them. But I thought this might be the kind of thing you guys would ask about. So let's see how they go. I've just taken the first one and I can already feel it growing a lot. Just had a bit of a walk. Someone here has got their favourite toy. Ooh. Oh my gosh, so speedy, so speedy. Oh, look at him go. He's so good, Weege. So good. He also walks around with it in his mouth, which is just the cutest thing ever. Hi. I'm clutching at straws, what to talk to you about. I really want to vlog and talk to you guys, but I hope you all can appreciate that there is really not very much to talk about. Not very much is happening. Oh, I bought a really nice new jacket. Let's talk about that. Saw it on TikTok, of all places, and just thought it was really cool. And ordered it. It was from a vintage shop based in, I want to say Belfast, that's probably wrong. It's called American Madness anyway. I'll link it in the description box. And it's like this reworked Carhartt jacket. They did it in lots of different colours. Oh God, I look like a slob today. They did it in lots of different colours. Show you in the mirror. It's really, really, really cool. So I got this colourway one. It was £95. It's all like padded inside, which is really nice. I have a size small, and just, I mean, it doesn't look great with these trousers, but just a really nice cut straight jacket, and just something a bit different. Colourful, but not too colourful. Warm, but not like a big coat. Just a really good piece. So that's at least something exciting to talk about. Really have been living in the same clothes day in, day out, obviously, due to not very much variation in life. And mostly being at home with this little one, who I can just hear somewhere with his toy. Where are you? Oh, he's here. Are you playing? Oh, can I have a look at, oh, there he goes. He walks around with his mouth, it's so cute. Can I see it, please? Where are you? Oh, what is it you've got? Are you going to show everyone how much you love it? Oh, distracted. He is just being so good. So much energy. Don't you? Don't you? Are you having a cuddle? I want a bite, of course. Of course, always trying to bite my hand. Aren't you? Go on, what's this? What's this? What have I got? Come here. Come here. Oh, you ready? Ah. Oh, try not to scratch that coat, please. Where are you going to take it? I'm going to play in the slippers. Everything. You like. Good morning, guys. Today's a new day. That day being Thursday, and I'm going to trim my fringe now. Couldn't find nail scissors. Don't know where they've gone, but a good workman never blames his tools. So I've adapted and I've brought the kitchen scissors instead for the fringe trim. As you can see, it's very long. Now the key to cutting your own fringe at home with kitchen scissors is to first say it grows back very quickly, and remind yourself that because it takes some of the pressure off, basically. And then the next step is to just go for it, little bits, nothing drastic, little tiny bits. Good God, okay. Where to begin? In the middle, let's do the middle. I don't know what's more stressful, watching me do this or me doing it. It's not bad. In all seriousness, if you do have a fringe and can't get it trimmed and locked down, my genuine tip is to do this like once every couple of weeks, because then you're only ever taking the tiniest bit off. so the margin for error is relatively small and you're still following the line that a professional has done rather than really freestyling yourself, which is obviously where it would all go really, really, really badly wrong. But yeah, you just want to always be taking the tiniest bit off. I can't believe I'm doing this and giving genuine, serious advice while I cut my fridge with kitchen scissors. Not bad. I think I've done an okay job there. Keep the side bits long. Wait till I can see a professional for that. But in the middle, not bad. So now that's been done and not disastrous effects, I'm going to make my bed will be my next steps. But also sign off this vlog and just say a big, maybe it's slightly disastrous. Anyway, like what was the thing we said at the beginning? Grows back, no pressure, no pressure. Yeah, thank you so much for watching. Thank you again to Jewellery for working with me on this. All the links, all of that will be in the description box. I really hope that you're all well and managing to muddle through these strange times, which I think is the best that we can all hope for right now. And yes, I will see you in the next video.